The concept for Operation X came as a result of the lack of communications following the passage of Hurricane Ivan, which devastated Grenada and other Caribbean territories some years ago. The Rainbow Radio League of St. Vincent and the Grenadines realized this shortcoming and conceptualized a field exercise that would provide radio operators with the skills and experience to meet the challenges of providing an adequate communication service in the aftermath of any disruptive event, especially if and when means of communications have been rendered inoperable. Operation X gives radio operators from neighboring territories the opportunity to visit all emergency shelters on that island, setting up and operating from these shelters using emergency radio equipment and power. This would allow officials stationed at the Emergency Operations Center to be in a better position to respond to the needs of that particular community, having been informed of their needs by radio operators on the ground. The field exercise was preceded by a map reading exercise to give responders the ability to traverse unfamiliar terrain using a map only, whereas the field exercise itself gave operators the opportunity to visit all emergency shelters and safe routes so that if they had to respond in the future, prior knowledge of that country would make their service less hazardous and more effective. Before the Grenadian contingent left for St. Vincent, Director of NADMA in Grenada, Mr. Sylvan McIntyre, interviewed some of the participants, including team leader Mr. Floyd Dowden.
This is the leader of the team, Floyd Dowden, has just gotten his boarding pass. Quite eager to leave or to depart Grenada, ensuring that all his instruments are in box and ready to go. And we will have his comments in a short while. Mr. Dowden, do you want to give us comments on camera about your departure, Operation X, and the anticipation?
Yeah, sure, Mr. McIntyre, thanks for the opportunity. In a sense, Operation X seeks to have a transfer of persons, an exchange of operators out of St. Vincent and Grenada. The exercise will take place today and tomorrow. We'll have a counter party that comes in from St. Vincent this morning of six persons, and a six-member team leaves for St. Vincent on the same flight that comes in. In essence, what the exercise will do is expose operators from Grenada to emergency shelters in St. Vincent and operators from St. Vincent to emergency shelters in Grenada. Having done that, we will do some field exercise in testing communication points, different points.
The field exercise, which ran over a period of 2 days, allowed participants to visit all emergency shelters on both islands. On completion of the two-day training exercise, NADMA's director, Mr. Sylvan McIntyre, again spoke with the participants to find out what they learned.
It was good. I learned a lot. The exercise was good. I hope that we continue doing the exercise in Grenada just the same. And it was a very good learnable exercise for me.
Tell us something about your trip. How was it?
Well, the trip was excellent. Everything went as planned. And it was a very, very good exercise. I really wish that we could execute all the little tips that we got from our friends in St. Vincent and really get to really realize the importance of wireless communication with our radios and everything like that. And so we could be much, much better prepared.
Mr. Dowden, leader of the team, we'd want you to make some comments. We did tell you that we were going to be here to capture the experience on your return. So now is your opportunity. Please tell us.
Okay, good afternoon, Mr. McIntyre. And first of all, let me say hats off to the organizers, Rainbow Radio League of St. Vincent, NEMO St. Vincent in conjunction with NADMA Grenada, for organizing and executing this exercise. The support that you guys gave made it possible. In my opinion, the exercise was a successful one. In my opinion, the objectives were met, which was to give the operators an opportunity to exchange territories, and that the St. Vincent guys were here, we were over in St. Vincent. I think what we have now is a core of Grenadian operators who know the terrain in St. Vincent, who know the emergency shelters and where they are, who know where are good operating points for radios, for wireless communication. It also gives the Vincentians a chance. So we have a team of Vincentians who know our emergency shelters and what our terrain is like and where are the best points for communication on the island. This can only serve our two countries well going forward, in that in the event of an emergency, we won't have our telephones to rely on. What we'll have to rely on is back to our HF radios, and we know a better understanding of the propagation points, where they are, where the good points. I suggest that another exercise should be continued sometime soon, which is, as the Rainbow Radio League of St. Vincent suggests, a radio mapping exercise. We will pinpoint areas on the island that are good takeoff points for radio communication between the islands. I also want to suggest strongly that as you come back here, that we let keep the momentum flowing. Keep it going, as I say, hit the iron while it's hot, so that going forward, we can institute some of the experiences that we have learned over there. And in the future, the exercise could be expanded to cover more islands in the territory, in the more territories in the region, and give us a wider scope of the operation. We look forward to great things for the committee going forward. And I'll say again, hats off to all those who helped. The sponsors, Liat contributed in some way, Scotia Bank, St. Vincent. The aircraft supporters, that's Mustique Airways, and Shell, former Sol, for donating the fuel for the aircraft. I think all in all, it was a good exercise, a successful operation. Of course, there were mistakes along the way, but that was the purpose of the exercise, to identify where these weaknesses are, so that going forward we can correct them, and not wait until something happens to try to fix them then. So I think we're in a good position now, and I'm really proud of the team who went. I'm happy to be part of the team. I'm very thankful to be part of the team. So we look forward to great things.
Operation X 2007 will again be held in Grenada and St. Vincent, but this time will run for 3 days, including all the inhabited Grenadine islands.